All right, Aqua Gang, what did you do? You already know it's your girl, Empress 777, here today with your almost daily love reading. I know you're like, girl, where the fuck we at now? I just felt the need intuitively, guys. The space was calling me for your read today, so just go with it. Holy angels and spirit guys, give me clear, concise messages for my Aqua Gang. Gang, my Aquarius family, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. It is general, may or may not resonate. You know how that goes, guys, okay? Take what does, leave the rest. Keep an open mind, open heart, as tarot is fluid. Cross watchers, put yourself where you belong in the story. Guys, go ahead and take a moment and click that like button, okay? So that our energies may circulate along this platform and make it to those who need it as well. And our family can continue to grow. We are growing. I'm just gonna say that. You know what I'm saying? Your girl is not complaining at all. We're growing super fast. So I do appreciate you guys. And thank you so much for all your love and support. Now, without further ado, let's get to the shit, okay? It wasn't a whole lot of chaotic energy in your meditation, I just have to say that, okay? So I was happy about that. I am interested to see where this read might go because I didn't feel any energy of the past, actually, okay? This is a general reading, so I'm curious to see where it's taking us here. So we have moonscape, okay, perspective, remote, right? That's movement. All right, so this definitely entails separation. I mean, that's evident, right? We have a part. We also have remote, so there has been some sort of movement. Now, guys, please, just follow me for a second. I know y'all not trying to fuck with shit from the past, but this remote is definitely standing out at me as someone who has made a few changes that you might want to take a second look at. I'm just saying. I'm not telling you what to do. It's free will. There is a perspective that has changed. Now, what people often don't realize is just because you have woken up, you know what I'm saying, doesn't mean that when you arrive to this destination that it could have quite possibly taken a moment for this person to get here. I'm not getting awakened energy or someone who's gone through a spiritual awakening, but I am getting the energy of someone who is actively taking their spirituality a little bit more seriously. They're viewing this connection as something more deeper than what they initially felt it was, right? I get the energy of someone who kind of thought that the feelings would just dissipate, that they would be able to move on quickly. This is someone who has not been able to get you out of their mind, okay? It's not obsession, but it's definitely a curiosity as to why you, out of all of their other connections, would still be remaining on a loop, especially if it's been quite some time since the disconnect of this connection, okay? So we have blood moon. I feel like this came out for you not long ago, all right? But these are coming out in the position of the energy of this person, whoever this person is, okay? It says deep dive, it says reset, and it says intensity. I feel like this person feels an intense pull, an intense chemistry. Definitely get soulmate energy in reference to what has come out thus far. This is somebody who is now wanting to make necessary changes, I believe, because they have not been able to shake this, okay? That is the driving force. That is why such an intense, high drive to be different, to be a different person, to move into a different perspective, a new insight on things. Two of you are apart. There is separation. But I feel like this is someone who is sort of, they're trying to understand you. You know what I'm saying? And that doesn't always come out. I don't know how far that's gonna go with you. You like, girl, fuck this shit. I'm just saying. It is someone trying to gain or yield a perspective, okay? Wow, so we have snake. Okay, now listen, guys, don't jump the gun, okay? Read the fine print, right? It says health, deceit, and sexuality. Here's the thing, this person definitely had lots of deceitful energy in the past. This person was more than likely operating out of bitterness and resentment for relationships that had failed them, relationships that had burnt them. This is someone who was a good person at one point in time. I'm just saying, you like, girl, they ain't shit. I'm just saying, guys. This is somebody who used to operate in a very healthy way in relationships, but they got burnt. Do you understand? And therefore, everyone after whoever burnt this person, it could have been two people in particular is what I'm hearing intuitively, whoever fucked this person over or broke them, essentially, like literally broke them for everyone who came there after, including you. So they've been getting away with this for quite some time. They kind of started to move different, right? I'm really on some fuck a bitch shit. That's what I just heard. I just heard a Biggie lyric. You know what I'm saying? It's like, I'm really on some F love shit, like after what I've been through. This is somebody who is definitely operating in the sense that they wanted to get back at whoever they date, get back at men, get back at women because of what they had gone through. They kind of correlated this heartbreak, this pain, this deception that they experienced themselves as the ultimate betrayal of the entire gender. So whoever came after was about to get this work, was about to get whatever it is that they had to give, okay? There is a harem, there is a flock, there is a cemetery, guys, of souls and bodies and people that they've left behind. You are the one that continues to linger. You are the one that definitely is making them question more than any other connection. And it is because they've been able to release those people. They may have left those people broken and heartbroken, sad, kind of in a really dark place, but they were themselves able to move on to the next, to the next. You may have a serial dater for some of you. You know if this is your person, right? This is someone hopping from one poom poom to the next, one dick to the next, okay? Sticking and moving, laying low and spreading it wide. The deceit falls in place when they meet the people, they're perfect. Then as soon as they feel the feelings, they start doing fuck shit, you know? They start to F people over. This person has gained a perspective on their patterns. They may have started or, you know, began to seek psychiatric help for this, guys. I mean, like a therapist, there's nothing wrong with that. I think therapy and shit like that gets a bad rap. We all need it at some point in time. We all have shadows that fucking mess with us or that sabotage, great shit, right? We all have the one that got away. Don't lie, don't lie, do not lie. So that is where this person is standing at this time. I know, Empress, girl, we don't give a flying fuck. We can't find one. Listen, if the motherfucker was on fire, I wouldn't blow on them. Like, I'll keep walking, you know? I get it. But you know what? The silver lining would be at least this person is figuring out their patterns so that they don't continue this. You know what I'm saying? This person puts a bad taste in your mouth. Ooh, we have Raven. Yeah, see? So message, inspiration, and prophecy. I feel like this person is dreaming about you. This person may be into spirituality heavy now, guys. Heavily into their spiritual journey. As I stated initially, I don't feel the vibes of an awakening. Nothing like that. Nothing that deep. But definitely questions. Definitely curiosity. A deeper dive. This is somebody who is possibly being faced with a mirror, right? They may have somebody in their sphere of friends or family that's breaking it down for them. Like, this is why. This is what is going on. And just because you can't seem to unwrap your mind from Aquarius, the distance between that shit, it's gonna be highly unlikely that that message gets through. It's gonna be highly unlikely that that message is received properly, okay? The communication in this relationship was fucked from the beginning. There was none. It was very hard to communicate with this person. It didn't matter what language you speak. You know, like, damn, it didn't matter what language. The two of you could never get on one accord communicatively, okay? So I definitely feel like we're dealing with somebody who is being left to truly realize the type of person that they have become. This is someone who subconsciously began to behave this way because of the insecurities that they gained and those connections that really broke them down, okay? So this person didn't always have an unhealthy outlook on relationships. This person used to actually be the perfect match. You even felt that. They were able to operate that way initially in connections, but something would switch in them, like a trigger. I believe for most of you, those triggers were emotions, you know? The emotions and the thought of being vulnerable and transparent, or the thought of actually having another relationship where, you know, you are in danger, right, of being heartbroken again. You are in danger of experiencing exactly what you experienced before. And with this person, as soon as the trigger would come, and it came in every single connection, including the one with yours, it's like a switch. You saw the switch. You saw the switch in their behavior. You saw the switch in the chemistry. You saw the switch in how much they communicated, how often you saw this person, what they were doing, you know what I'm saying? How they were talking, the language, all of that shit changed like with a blink of an eye. You kind of chalked it up to, oh, this is, they were, you know, this is somebody who's wearing a mask. This is someone whose mask slipped. Some of you gave them a couple of chances, but you just kept hitting this brick wall, you understand? The beginning of the connection, you're not tripping, okay? The chemistry was real. The connection was real. The magnet between the two of you, still very much so there. Don't lie. Don't lie. Don't lie. Don't fuck me up and don't lie. It's still there. You are trying your damnedest to release this shit. You can't stand the thought of still feeling connected to this. There is a bit of remorse here, guys. I just have to say that. Y'all know. You know I'll dig into their ass if necessary. I just don't feel that. This is somebody who is actually taking an analysis. This is someone who is actually self-reflecting. This is not someone pointing the finger at this point. Whoever, whatever conversation they had, this could be a conversation that they've had with spirit, something that they have come across or had a prophecy about in a dream or in a meditation. Like I said, this is someone who is really turning more to spirituality. They hit some sort of a brick wall in their life in general, right? A very karmic cycle for this person, where they're forced. This is a tower moment for them, guys. Let's make no mistakes about that. So we have turnt, okay? A state of being wild, acting wildly, drugs, alcohol, sex at a crazy party, drunk and excited. So this is the energy that this person may have turned into. Do you understand? It was duality here. Two different people. I feel as though this person did want exclusivity. They did want a relationship. They did want to be with you. They felt it with you more than any other connection. It's just these demons would not allow them to act right. There was no act right. It just would not allow them to behave. It would not allow them to fully see this head on. Okay. I'm seeing the Sun card. All right. Even though I'm not doing tarot just yet, I just see the Sun card popping out. So the way that I view that, or the way that I am experiencing that or hearing this message, is that's how they view you. They viewed you as the Sun. Now, please tell me, can I get a show of hands? How many of y'all could just stare at the Sun and not look away? It is not a thing. You cannot do that shit. You will blind yourself. You cannot look at that shit head on, okay? So this person definitely wanted to pursue this. They wanted to do right. It's just there is something else heavier, something else deeper, something else stronger, a stronger force within them that just would not allow them to look at the Sun. It was blinding for them, okay? Whew, child. It's really sad, guys. I feel like the sex was the bomb for those of you who were intimate with this person. That's definitely something at the forefront of their mind. You know, who you fucking and who been fucking you, okay? Yes, definitely something. So it's not a lie, guys, okay? We have Swole. This is the millennial deck, by the way, which I love. It's really cute, and it's very creative. Anyway, the way I'm viewing this card is, this is somebody who is, so I'm not looking at it from the physical standpoint. This is somebody making changes internally, okay? These are changes that will actually show and prove. Shook, all right? So can't believe what you heard. Caught off guard, unsettled. That's what's sticking out, okay? Unsettled and speechless. So this is definitely somebody who has been around the block, okay? They've been around, all right? No Tupac. They were expecting to just bounce over this, you know? Come back from this. Take this L, come back from it, and hop right back on any other site and start swiping left, swiping right, okay? That's what they expected. That's exactly the opposite of what they got, okay? The exact opposite. This is somebody who now is viewing the attraction of themselves as something that they don't understand why you were attracted to them. They don't understand why you would have given them a chance. This is somebody who views themselves the same way that you're viewing them. The two of you are mirroring each other. They understand the capacity in which they've hurt you. They understand the level of trust in which they have broken things down to you. Like, what trust? There ain't no motherfucking trust here. That shit gone, gone, gone. Oh boy. This person is working hard at changing themselves. Like, actually, wow. Can't make this up, guys, okay? Now listen, I know you're not fucking with the past. I know you're not. And here's the thing. I can't even be mad at you. I cannot. Listen, I get it. How much time are you going to give to one situation? How much time do you have to waste? Because this shit is not going to happen overnight. This person is working at changing themselves, and they do have the right tools at this time. I feel like they've surrounded themselves with a new set of people, a new group of people. I don't know. They've encountered a different set of energies that has them operating in this way. If you've known this person for years, you wouldn't even be able to recognize them if the two of you were to encounter each other now. That is just how deep the changes are thus far. Still not an awakening. It is changes though, and this is somebody who's working very hard at releasing the shit that sabotages their relationships over and over and over. Releasing the shit that makes them toxic, you know, to connections, to people that they love. This person has messed up connections in their actual family, I just heard. You know? Wow. So the pain really ran deep, okay? I feel as though you were a catalyst to get this person to this point. It's taken them a long time to get here. They never felt the need to want to change. This is not somebody who felt like they needed to change. They felt like they were dealt a bad hand of cards in life. They felt like they were done wrong. So them wreaking havoc in everybody else's life, they felt like was their due diligence. This is what they were owed. This behavior, okay? It's sad. It's really, really sad because I do feel like there was love here, all right? Regardless, I know, don't get on me down in them comments. Bitch, that ain't love. Turn this shit off. Okay, I'm just saying. I do. I just have to go with what I feel. Y'all know that. There were feelings here. This person doesn't know how to operate in that way, though, you see? It says rebound. I just needed someone to help me get over the pain of losing you. So here's the thing, guys. I told you, they have tried to move on multiple times. And they'll go a certain amount of time and let you be. And then before you know it, they're hitting you up again. And you're like, damn, fuck, shit. Please. Please, please, please just go and be somewhere else, right? Exist somewhere else. You no longer exist to me, motherfucker. Why are you back? Why? Why are you here? Oh, boy. So let's take a look here at the shadow that this person may be struggling with. One of them, they are struggling with several. It says knowing your, oh my God, you cannot make this shit up. You can't make it up, guys. It's a very specific storyline. It says knowing your own darkness is the best method for dealing with darkness of other people. This person definitely projected their own hurts, their own insecurities, their own sense of lack, right? Their own lack of sense of self-worth. They would project that onto others, and they accumulated all of those negative traits, all of those negative aspects within themselves from heartbreaks of the past, which they then put inside, right? It's like, I'm good. On to the next. It's whatever it is, what it is. Meanwhile, they were just suppressing it, right? Which then brews as resentment and bitterness, which then comes out as like revenge on whoever is next, okay? Totally subconsciously done, but they are at the point now where they're trying to know their own darkness. Forget what the people of the past did. They're trying to work beyond this pain, guys. They're trying to work beyond this trauma. There may have been something that you even said to them or brought to their attention about what they were doing or how they behaved, about their character, something very particular. Please, this is for someone particular, okay? So take this if it resonates. There was something that you mentioned to them about their character or about the way that they was moving or handling you that really spiked their curiosity. This is how they have ended up down this rabbit hole, right? Like I said, you were the catalyst to get them to this point. So it's not terrible, but silver lining would be that they would actually heal from this and be better for those in the future, even if the two of you don't come back together. I don't think they want to hear that. That's not at the forefront of their mind. I don't really think that that's what they're trying to hear right now. It's definitely somebody who's being optimistic about working hard. Like, if I work hard, if I put in the work and really show and prove and show up as a different person, then that's my person. That we belong together. We're soulmates. You know I fucked it up. I know I was fucked up inside, which had absolutely nothing to do with you, but I fucked you over. You real good over and over and over, and now here I am back, right? It sounds absurd, guys. I'm just gonna say that. You like, you think, do you hear yourself talking, girl? Do you hear yourself? All right, so let's dig a little bit deeper here. I'm gonna wrap this shit up. I be trying not to talk too long. Y'all know I like to run my mouth. So we're gonna use the Mystic Beast official unofficial deck, y'all. She was in the comments on my last video. I was totally fanning out. So what's up, girl? I F's with your channel too. You are, girl, you're the truth. All right, so let's get to this. This is her oracle deck. Let's see what we got here. All right, so see, I almost let them destroy our connection. Wow. What they mean by almost, though? You like, that shit is destroyed. It is in the gutter. It is burnt to a pulp. It is burnt to oblivion. They're like, let it go. As Elsa would say, let that shit the fuck go. Oh, God. So by them, they mean connections of the past. Okay? This person might have been cheated on, right? Done real dirty, y'all. Used. Okay, if you were in a connection, so it's going to be different for all of you, right? Whatever their trauma is, it's definitely something that has affected them moving forward in their life. It's been really sabotaging all of their connections, really, even with their family. Like, that shit is deep, yo. But most importantly, they talking about the connection with you. They know they fucked this shit up, okay? I almost let them destroy our connection. So it's the bitterness and the resentment. For those of you who were dealing with someone who was truly selfish, okay? Selfish to the highest bestivity. I mean, it was like pulling teeth trying to get even a phone call out this bitch. It was like pulling teeth to try to even get, you know, the bare minimum, right? Like the bare minimum. What you would normally charge people to even know your name, this person, it was like pulling teeth just to get that very bare minimum shit from them. And it is because they were used, okay? They were, there was a connection in particular that they dealt with in the past where they gave it all and they lost it all. Do you see what I'm saying? Oh, God. It says, if only you knew how much I love you. I told you. You're like, girl, I don't want to hear that shit. Wow. They never express their feelings. This is not somebody who is emotional. This is somebody who is very much so not emotional. You're an Aquarius though, so it's cool. You know what I'm saying? We're not all that emotional either. That's okay. You know, you don't need somebody who's gonna wear their heart on their sleeve, be super emotional, be, you know, using their emotions to make decisions, an emotional lunatic, goddamn. We don't need that, right? So that's fine. But the part that's not fine is not even remotely resembling any actions of love. It's the actions for you, okay? Period. Because you can say you love me all day and still be a fuck boy, okay? A fuck girl, okay? You can still be total bullshit, you know? They do love you guys. I'm just gonna say that. The love is there. You loved them too. Or you either loved them already, and that is why this persisted, or you definitely saw that, right? You saw it getting there initially, with their behavior initially, that quickly changed. All that shit quickly changed. Says, yep. So this is someone just kind of watching from a distance. They don't want to get burnt, right? Like they will temperature check at some point in time, but I feel like they know that they haven't made it far enough out of this character that they was before. They haven't made enough of a difference in who they are and enough progress in this healing to come back around. Okay, that would almost be the detriment of this for most of you. I don't get the idea that all of you are walking away. Okay, don't say that. Don't beat me up. I just gotta go with what I feel intuitively. But it'll be quite some time before this can get to a balanced connection, okay? Something that even remotely resembles a normal, healthy connection, okay? I need to tell you how I truly feel. See? They're not doing it now, though. I don't feel any movement. This person is solely focused, okay? Zeroed in, tunnel vision almost, on becoming who it is that they need to be in order for you to not turn this away. They don't wanna lose. Wow. Yikes, yikes, yikes. What are we dealing with here? All right, so. What does this person feel the heart of the matter is here? Yeah, oh, see, they know that they were stingy, selfish guys, very, very selfish, holding on to everything for themselves, worried about themselves, trying to figure out where things were going for themselves, you know? Worrying about what you was gonna do for them. That type of shit, even though they had it. This is definitely somebody who felt like they had to hold on to everything, hold on to it all, hold on to my thoughts, my feelings, hold on to my money, my time, my effort, hold on to all of that. Because in the past, they did risk it all. And they lost that shit. It was the ultimate gamble. I feel like this person, whoever that was that fucked them over, the flags were there, okay? They just ignored them. So we can't even feel like too sorry, but I get it. But they are just now using that as an excuse for this behavior, okay? They're making everyone else pay. Wow. So they do know that that is the heart of the matter, guys. What do they believe the challenges in this is? Nine of Pentacles. You prefer to be single. You would much rather, listen, I could do bad all by myself, motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? I don't need nobody. Quite literally, okay? So they feel like the challenge now is going to be getting you past this mindset of being single. You are pre-empress, pre-emperor, okay? They do know the value that you hold. And you could see their value at some point in time too, but after a certain amount of time, it's like the value is there, but you're holding on to all of it for yourself? Like, blatantly? Like, purposefully? Like, nah, fuck that. I'll be alone. Listen, it's a line around the corner, goddamn, okay? People is waiting to get in this bitch, so Please, you know, exit stage left. See yourself out. One yourself, my G. Like, get out. So, what are your expectations moving forward? See, guys, it's so wild how these storylines just fall into place. It just makes sense. It all makes sense, guys. You cannot make this up. So Knight of Swords in the reverse, it's like a ultimate standstill, a halt. They are not moving. I told you, I felt that. There is no movement. Okay. We have the make them prove it card that came out. So this is definitely what they are feeling. Your mindset is at, for those of you who will still engage with this, it is something that is truly divinely guided, okay? The universe has been trying to get this person to this juncture in their life, to healing this shit for so long. For so long. They've been moving slow as molasses. And now it's to a halt. It's to a stop. They will not be moving towards you. Their expectations are to bring this to a complete stop, a complete overhaul. They do know that returning, they can never be the same. It could never be the same. It could never be the same. There needs to be a death moment here, okay? This is somebody who needs to transform completely. They do know that, and that will take time. So there is no movement. All right, so how they feel you've influenced things. Well, you gave and gave and gave, okay? You had all the gifts. You had all of the time. You had all the money. You had all the ideas. You had all of the effort, okay? I mean, just an endless well. This is somebody who definitely feels like you balanced their life. You balanced their energies, okay? That shit is heavy. Let me just say that, okay? You dealing with someone who is truly insecure, bitter, very, very bitter. That's some heavy shit to try and always get a person to see you, to try and always get a person to realize who they are, to try and always get a person to see the beauty in things and the beauty in life. You don't have time for that. You got other shit to do. And furthermore, there are other people, okay, vowing for your time. Who are more equipped, more qualified, okay? So while you brought a true balancing energy to this person's life, what did they bring to your life? Can somebody please answer me that? Please put it in the comments. Like, what did they bring here? What they could have bought, they held on to for themselves, right? They held on to it for themselves. Or for them other bitches, you know what I'm saying? Them other guys, like. So please, what did you get out of this deal? So this is definitely how this person feels you've influenced this. They know that they got, that you got the shorter end of the stick in this, okay? Take an accountability. So I cannot be mad at this. I'm not telling you what to do. And I'm not telling you that this will happen overnight, these changes, this. There's still no cards of awakening. All right. So we can't ignore that. There needs to be a transformation. Don't know how long that's going to take. But this person is definitely on track, guys. And it feels genuine. And it feels organic. It feels authentic. It feels like something that they want to do. You can't change people. They got to want to change for their fucking selves. You see what I'm saying? So this person is now at a point where they actually see the necessity in changing. It is necessary. It is imperative, actually, if they want to be successful moving forward, even if not with you. Okay? So let's go on over to the extended. I want to see what the reason for this person's behavior is ultimately. We'll take a deeper look into these traumas of the past that they're currently working on. I also want to see what their subconscious blockages and fears are. Also want to take a look at what karma this person may currently be experiencing or experiencing in the near future. Incoming influences that will affect the outcome of this. That's going to be more for you. Something that you need to look out for. Signs. We'll also see what this person's next step are going to be, their intentions. That is most important, and the potential outcome if you decide to engage with this again or go in the opposite direction. There's no judgment there, of course, you know. We'll also look at your spirit messages. Why would this situation be present in your life right now? Why would you have to experience this? What does the universe have in mind making you go through this shit? We'll also see what you might be missing on your self-love journey. This would be considered a blockage in reference to why you may have been meeting the same people or why there's been stagnation in your love life in general. We'll also see what lessons need to be learned in order for you not to encounter the same toxic energies, in order for you to only be visible to healthy individuals. Let's see what your focus needs to be to rebuild your trust and love, okay? Because I do feel like that's been compromised. And then we'll also see what your focus advice needs to be in order for you to find true divine happiness and love and life in general, okay, guys? First, click that like button though, okay? Click that subscribe button. I thank you guys so much for all your love and support. Now let's go on over there. We're gonna dig into this, okay? Let's cut up a little bit. It's gonna be linked down below. I'll see you over there.